I always obsess about this idea of people living a deliberate life, which is deciding how you want your life to be, then figuring out what you have to do to make that happen. There's this famous quote by George Bernard Shaw, and I don't remember exactly how the quote goes, but the long and the short of it is something along the lines of reasonable people accept things the way they are, and unreasonable people want to make the world the way they want it to be, and they don't accept things as they are. So maybe to get the life that we want, the dream that we want, we have to be a little unreasonable. And when I think of unreasonable, think of my dad. My dad always wanted the world to be the way he wanted it to be, regardless of whether it was that way or not. So when I was growing up, I'm like, Dad, I'm cold. And he's like, no, you're not. I'm like, Dad, my shoes hurt. No, they don't. Dad, I'm wet. No, you're not. And I'm like, oh, yeah, all right. And I just kind of kept going. And I've tried to instill this in my children, but it's not working. I tell them, you know, Urich boys are tough. And I say, Dad, we're cold. I'm like, no, you're not. And they're like, yes, we are. And then I don't know what to say, because whenever my dad told us we weren't, we just kept on going. But anyway, here's the story that kind of defines how severely my father wanted the world to be the way he wanted it to be. For years, I took students to New York City. My father grew up in New York City. And although he grew up in New York City, he doesn't really recall anything about where anything is in New York City. He actually told me that with a straight face they had moved the subway tunnels since he was there. So we're standing there, we're going to see the UN, and I got 25 Oklahomans back in the 90s. We come out of the subway near Grand Central Station. We're trying to get to the UN, which would be east of Grand Central Station. So we come out of the door, and you can't tell which door you are. You don't know which way the streets are going yet. So I say to my dad, I think that's east. And my dad says, that's east, and points exactly the other direction. And I'm going to use a term that is a not polite term here coming up, and I just wanted to give a disclaimer. It's the GD word is what my father's going to end up saying, and I just wanted to point out that in Oklahoma, a lot of people don't like that word, but that word in New York, where my father grew up, is an article, right? So, for example, in Spanish, you would say el sombrero. In New York, you say goddamn hat, right? It's just what happens. So we're standing there arguing. I say that's east. He says that's east. One of my young Oklahomans comes to the rescue and says, it's 10 o'clock in the morning. He says, look, it's the sun. And my father says, I don't care where the goddamn sun is. That's east. And that was the way that he approached life. And while on one hand, it's a bit of a nut job. On the other hand, we had a ton of fun. We did a lot of exciting things, and you have to have a certain commitment to make the world the way you want it to be.